Okay, that's a lie, man. I'm not 6 foot. I know most of you see a guy with one leg. Let me assure the ladies in the house, I'm still definitely working with two. I lost my leg in a bike accident. Got hit by somebody who had one too many. True story. I'll make it quick. This cat hit me in a Ford Focus. He fled the scene in a Ford Escape. That's true shit. I don't hold a resentment against the cat, but I hate fucking Fords. You know, my message is we all got problems, just different ones, so we deal with them how we deal with them. Some worse than others, you know. I survived this shit by doing lots and lots of fucking drugs. But there comes a time in everybody's life you start getting hints. Like for me, numerous times sitting at a stop sign, telling myself, God damn, this motherfucker ain't gonna turn green. Yep, getting burnt the fuck out. Then all my friends around me start going to jail and prison for dope. Fuck, I can't go to jail and prison, man. I'm telling you what, I drop the soap all the fucking time. You try shampooing your hair in the tub on one fucking leg. Fuck that bar of soap. Shit. You know, life goes on. You know, little things used to piss me off after my accident. Little things. Like people with two fucking legs. Or how about that fucking IHOP? What kind of goddamn name for any fucking establishment is fucking IHOP? Can you see me going in this fucking place? Yeah, I don't pay me to eat fucking pancakes. IHOP. I'm gonna go to my grave pissed off about this one, man. The fact that I gotta pay for two goddamn shoes when you can clearly see I only need fucking one. How did these motherfuckers live with themselves, sending a one-legged guy out the fucking door with two shoes knowing good goddamn well one's for the wrong fucking foot? Motherfuckers. You know them people who say you can't learn nothing good on drugs? Bullshit. I beg to differ. I learned lots of good knowledgeable shit on drugs. Like long hair, super long hair? That shit's extremely flammable. Learn that shit on drugs. I also learned that the way to the ladies' hearts definitely ain't through no fucking restraining orders. But I had a leg up on a restraining order shit. Come to find out, restraining orders, they don't stick. Not if you lose the bracelet and the goddamn ankle. Then they throw that shit right up. You know, life gets lonely for an amputee, you know, man. Ladies, I lost my leg, not my dick. You know, life can get lonely, I start thinking stupid shit, like, goddamn, I wish I had some titties on my back to play with. Because titties are good, right? Don't tell me I'm the only son of a bitch in here who likes titties. Well, the more I thought about it, with my luck, I get a fucking breast cancer. Now, how fucked up would I look with one titty and one leg? Fucked up. So I started seeing this girl that's next door to me. Well, peeking in her window, so I'm not exactly sure which way our relationship is headed. I know, I can't believe I'm doing it myself. She lives on the third fucking floor. God damn, I must really like this one. You know, I know you can't tell by looking at me, but ladies, if pussy were candy, all my teeth would be rotting the fuck out. Now that I'm not doing dope anymore, just cocktails, but I limit myself to one, right after the other always, usually. You know? Fucking no dope, just cocktails, and I often dream of owning my own liquor store, right? Then I run out and change my last name to Pussy. I call the joint Pussy Liquors. Come on, that's original. God damn. You know, I know this shit looks like it's bad and all, but fuck, I count my blessings. It could have been worse. I could have been bald. Shit. God damn, I got lucky, you know? I got me a dog recently. I didn't think that shit through. I just said, I'm getting a man's dog, a big dog. Fuck them out of pocket purse pussy dogs. I ain't having it. So I got the first thing I could find, a St. Bernard. Anybody know how a one-legged guy walks in St. Bernard? He fucking don't. I learned something else about the St. Bernards. When they hump your leg, you let them finish. And you ain't got a goddamn choice. He's a big bastard, but he's gentle. Goddamn. So life goes on. I'm glad I can laugh about this shit with everybody, you know? Fucking, I've been traveling with a guy named Kevin Kraft, opening up for him. And we were recently in Talladega, Alabama. I was driving, he was sleeping. Fucking, I get pulled over speeding. Hillbilly state trooper comes up to my window. And the minute I roll the window down, he's like, boy, I smell marijuana on you. You got marijuana on you? I looked right at him and said, yes, sir, officer, but I don't smoke it. He didn't know what to think. He got us out of his car and he ripped his rental car apart. Didn't find any marijuana. He said, boy, I thought you said you had marijuana on you. I said, I do, officer, right here, but I don't smoke it. He didn't find that shit funny at all, man. I'm telling you what. And Kevin's a black man. He was pissed off, man. That's a long way riding home from Talladega to Minnesota with a big pissed off black dude next to you. God damn. So I'm living another day to fight another war, because that's what we do. I'm feeling good nowadays. I'm thinking I'm looking good. I got a new pair of glasses on, thanks to this young lady, whom I didn't expect to cross her legs so quick. Got me a new pair of glasses out the deal. Shit. So how's everybody doing tonight? You guys enjoying everybody? Give it up for everybody who was up here already. Awesome. You know, I often get this, you know, are you a veteran? You been to war or what? No, sir, only when I go to titty bar, because then it's free leg dances for me and all my friends, because I'm a goddamn war hero there. Shit. Yeah. So, this is what I do now. I just go around trying to make them. Hey, give it up. We got a fucking celebrity in the crowd. Fancy Ray is here. Huh? Give it up. I'm telling you what, that's one of you looking motherfucker, man. I think twice about fucking him. Alright. Last time I was here, man, I was on my way down here. I didn't know it was a gay establishment, which I don't have any problems with that. Each is their own, right? You know? But within the first 10 minutes of being in here, I was texting every guy friend I got. Hurry up, get down here, I need a boyfriend, quick! But I'll say, man, this is a friendly place, man. I love this fucking stage, the stage rules, the guy who runs the show is fucking awesome. You gotta give it up for him, huh? You know, all them people who say tattoos are forever, the fuck they are! They used to piss my old girlfriend off, man. They ain't forever no more, biatch! How much time I got?
You're over.
I'm over! Well, how many guys? You know what? Hey, my friends call me the righteous one. If you ain't cool with that, you can call me IHOP. I don't give a shit.